the worst non-storm affected underwriting year of the last two decades, but with premium income still at a historic high. That's what Willis says, that will this affect the underlying softening dynamic? Here, if we see the portfolios, this is provided by Lloyd's, still looks profitable. So that's what I said, that we should have some smile on our faces. It's not that scary. Of course, the market, what we have seen regionally has been affected. But if you see the Lloyd's falling hurricane, like in 2008, Lloyd's upstream portfolio still looks profitable, although the 2010 year is bound to deteriorate significantly during 2011. Upstream market dynamic. Before the recent losses, the period of false equilibrium was coming to an end at the beginning of 2011. What is false equilibrium? Because in every industry, if you see, there has been a balance and which has to be created. And that balance is a fiscal balance on the balance sheet. When a order book, if it is the same way in the insurance industry, if we talk about the capacities were over, an average rating level, if at that particular point of time, also estimated average rate index was very high at that particular time, which was giving an giving a balance, and all of a sudden, when the disaster of Gulf of Mexico, which happened, and then we saw the rating from the same industry went drastically down. We see, if you remember, just off tangent, the Lehman Brothers, when they went for filing the liquidity and solvency, they 15 days before they were A plus. So that's what the situation is. Upstream market dynamic, 2011. Energy, you can see before the recent losses, the period of false equilibrium was coming to an end at the beginning of 2011. So now we talking about downstream. So downstream are beginning to compete for business in a manner not seen since the last truly soft market in 99 and 2000. While North American market capacity remained stable, its international counterpart continued to grow. Various markets became more prominent. Following a benign underwriting year in 2009, the portfolio remained profitable. And if you see the degree of aggression shown by individual insurers we were talking about here is now driving competition in the market. We were talking about that, rather than overall capacity. So regional market are contributing to the softening process. Now in the downstream, the same way, if you see the capacity, while North American downstream market capacity remains stable, its international counterpart continues to grow. The recent, if you see profitability in the downstream, the recent Canadian oil sands upgrader loss, that was the biggest, if you see, has already had a major impact on the downstream loss. And if we see from the Lloyd's perspective, despite its increasingly soft market condition, Lloyd's downstream property portfolio continues to look profitable. So the improved loss record since 2001 may well be down to general improvement in risk control and mitigation by the downstream industry, encouraged by the risk engineering approach taken by the market in recent years. The downstream market dynamic, if you see here, downstream capacities and average rating level. And this is, I have taken from 93 to 2011, provided by Willis, these are the source. So onshore capacity, where it went to nearly 5.5, and then again came down drastically, and then again went up, you can see the graph there. So estimated average rate index is balanced. Now, we talked about upstream, we talked about downstream. Let's talk about marine insurance, which is talking about the vessel side, or hull and machinery we are talking about. The global insurance market, we know that it is in flux. Asia, the confidence is growing. Europe, regional strength and international capacities, we can see that is rising. Scandinavian and down, but not out from the fray. The United States, the pricing are rising, going up. London market traveling well. And let me just give a little bit of highlight here, that markets move closer to customer, that today we have to go closer to the customer. Asia gains confidence, Europe flexes muscles, Scandinavian takes stock, US sees price rises, London remains at the center of innovation. Always London comes with innovative products, so they still remains at the center of the innovation. And Hull and Machinery challenges ahead. A decade of underwriting returns, downturn hits investment income, Hull values are falling, increasing reinsurance cost, underwriters press for rate rises, premium volumes fall, plentiful capacity is there. And if we talk about PNI, signs of stability, clubs take decisive action, big claims drivers, time lag, asset relocation, regulation, here especially the vessels which are working in this Persian water sometime crosses the boundary which are not allowed as per European and sanctions and even UNO and US sanctions. There PNI has a major role to play. And in the conclusion, I can say that we have plenty of options open for buyers, but beware of the long-term implications. The current market conditions are now causing insurers to think again about long-term policies. Recently, the unrest in the MENA region has led to an increased interest in strikes, riot, and civil commotion coverage. Insurance companies are exploring other methods of risk financing other than the traditional insurance. And if I have to talk about myself, like the intelligent insurance broker can help identify and quantify risk and bring them under control. They can create and implement customized solution employing the most effective blend of risk mitigation, risk transfer, and advanced risk financing. This is, I'm talking with to the converts, so I don't have to. In the conclusion, I can say, considering all above explanation, I do not anticipate a drastic increase in rates, particularly for 2011, rather will expect each market to be rated separately, taking into account their exposure and experiences across industry. Here, one thing I want to add here, that we talk about consolidation, we spoke about mergers and acquisition because of the market dynamics, and we saw like over capacity and then competitions killing each others and all. But then one thing which I feel is that there should be an approach from the insurance community to the regulator to convince, or which should be for the benefit of all, which I feel should be a segregated approach. If we say segregated approach is that today, if my core competency in my industry, if I'm good in marine and offshore, I should be given a privilege to act on that particular area, leave someone for life and someone for general. And this is my idea, which I thought I should bring here as well. So, food for thought. Is it the time for change? Think outside the box. I believe we all have to think of. We can't take what steps which we have been going on the footprint of my predecessors, because the era which are coming and after the recession and whatever the catastrophe I spoke about, we never observed that in history. So it's the time when we should think outside the box, some innovative approach. Thanks for your attention. If any question answer, I'll be prepared to answer you. I love to do so. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. Just wait in case there's any questions. No, good man. A very, very comprehensive presentation, I think you'll all agree, and I'm grateful to George for finishing in good order to allow Mr. Hassan to run as long as he did, but we're still on track. So there is room for questions. So please.